trick. Here's what we gotta be doing. Okay, bike comes along. Okay, this is the next big one for the boys to be doing. Okay, rolling into a stoppy, pop. This is like, I've seen guys do this with cages. There's no cage. This is straight up. Pop into a stoppy, front flip. Bam, back wheel, 12 o'clock. You know what I'm saying? That's where it's gotta go.
Anakin Slade.
Yeah.
Don't judge a book by its cover or its culture. I'm bringing 95 back. Listen, yo, I came to finish this. You see the rap game trigger this. The battle's still over, I'll have the fat dame singing this. With a phrase spoken, I disable opponents. Like periodic table, I can label your components. The S for dull style, BR for bland rhymes. Like the Transformers Matrix, I'm in my prime. I scream,
MTL.
Now this verse is territorial. When stepping in the section, be expecting a tutorial. A hip-hop lesson, give your best to those blessing. And walk away unscathed and live to fight another session. My meticulousness versus your fickleness is just plain ridiculous. I even ticklish at your frivolousness. To those who pose and step in this direction, it's like stopping teen pregnancy. Don't bust without protection. I call the soul spit and I'm replacing the name. Takeover's like a makeover, change the face of the game.
Don't even know my flow. Haven't seen my show. I come to this game with my heart on my sleeve, and I got no choice left but to blow. I know I've been down, I've been low, headed straight to the top because I got nowhere else left to go.
I'm a distinguished linguist. My fire's hard to extinguish because I come like William Wallace and slaughter your English. It's the Lionheart firing darts at counterparts' hearts. The 21st century state-of-the-art Mozart, the prodigy. I leave MCs weak at the knees as I ease with the breeze like Zhang Ziyi with the trees. Now Bill Gates jealous because I'm word perfect. As I excel, check the windows because it's for sure curtains. In these days, artistic integrity is seldom seen. MCs saying the letters of the name like this is a spelling bee. A-double-N-A-K-I-N till I end them. I'm Mr. Fantastic to standards, I extend them. It's obscene the way I use MCs as a latrine and leave them enviously green when I'm Bill Bixby mean. And he's the fine, simple minds trying to define. It's like snorting cocaine shit,
yeah,
the dangerous
don't
lines.
Even know my flow. Haven't seen my show.
Something people should know about this sport before they get into it is don't go out there and buy a $10,000 bike and crash it. Don't try to stunt something that's expensive. Go out, get yourself an old F4I, you know, just older. From someone who used it as a race bike, or get a crash bike. 900s, old 900 CBRs were good. They are still good. They were some of the best. Now the guys want all fuel injected, but don't get a brand new bike and stunt it. That's just a waste of money.
Yeah, I see guys get out on freaking brand new R1s and brand new freaking CBRs and shit. I'm like, dude, man, you like stunting? You're gonna do it on that thing, and you're gonna crash from that. You're gonna wreck your bike. You're gonna stunt, get yourself an older bike, get yourself something at least been crashed out. You know what I mean?
You don't have to be beat stealing. This battle's like merging traffic. Y'all keep yielding. My elite fleet completes defeats with concrete beats. MCs retreat to easy street when we compete. I bring punch to the speakers. My attack stuns the weaker and leave you speaking incomprehensible like Bunsen Beaker. Yeah, what you thought I was kidding?
Y'all don't even know my flow. Yeah. Haven't seen my show. I come to this game with my heart on my sleeve, and I got no choice left but to blow. I know. I've been down, I've been low, headed straight to the top because I got nowhere.
Make sure you practice what you're gonna do somewhere out of the way. Get good at it before you take it out on the streets. Because obviously you're going to want to show off what you can do, but don't take it out on the street until you know you can do it every time perfectly.
Apart from that, you know, yeah, man, you got to work at it hard. Just, you know, have fun. You know, this thing is about having fun. That's the name of the game.
Stunt riding just seems to attract a different kind of crowd. Guys are just trying to perfect their skills and kind of make the bike do something that it was never designed to do in the first place. So it's just something different, something fun to do.
My name's Gaston. I'm a stunt performer, motorcycle stunt rider.
My friends call me Izzy.
Hi, my name's Tony, and I'm a police officer.
My name's Dave, and some guys call me Super Dave.
I am a crane operator. I work for a steel fabrication company.
What do? I work in a motorcycle store called Fifth Gear.
My name's Bill. I own Fifth Gear Motorsports.
I'm not a mechanic, but I just sort of work on bikes and help out and all that sort of stuff.
And we also run a stunt school.
I have my own little sort of stunt companies called Hard Knock Stunts. I don't just do bike stuff. I do a lot of stunts in the film industry as well. That's kind of my main bread and butter.
Would you ever abuse your bike like that, Dave?
No. A bike is not meant for those type of destructive nature tactics.
It's LAV, having a good motherfucking time, it's every day. You know what I'm saying? Check it. Badass ride the scooter, barrel cooler. Grew up little bit, then became a shooter. 6 grams, I'ma charge for 7. That'll cost 11. Fifth scale, he's a lobster living. Get the same love monsters giving. Trying to sit at the same table with Foxy living. Two arms with Foxy women, and they socks is hidden. Casino nights, so rocks forbidden. But I still slide them through the door. Plus 3 max, 2 packs, nigga, all strapped to a horse. Listen, man, we like Mickey D's. Come check the store. Fast food, Big Macs galore. You know I spit facts for sure. Listen, y'all spit shit, so you need Tic Tacs and more. I can bring the pack.
Yeah, I think the police should be educated. I think a lot of them associate stunt riders and sport riders with sort of an old guard mentality that they're bikers, like they're, you know, badass bikers that are associated to some organized gang that are gonna cause problems through the town.
Matter of fact, while I'm there, I'ma teach y'all to package raw. Yo, yeah. Every day, these cats gossip and spread rumors. Forget humor, worse, it's a cancerous head tumor. Anything we said to you is what it is. Dibs, gun, button, kids, if these kids in our biz. I had enough of this. Sniff is the gutterer, swinging an uppercut of fist. Then he spit another diss. This click of brothers is the sickest that you ever heard. Rest assured, the Smith will verbally murder every word. Me and LAV might have to slap these fags around. Just cop the new queen, wrapped up, bag and crown. So me and LAV came here to take the throne and run through your ozone. I'm the rap Capone. I got two ruthless fists that'll crack your dome. Cats threaten me cause they baby mom back the bone.
You know, I think stunt riders need to be educated with the police too about what's going on, and you know, I'd like to see sort of sanctioned areas given, saying that, you know what, alright guys, if you're out hanging out over in this parking lot, or you're hanging out over in this street or whatever, we're not gonna give you a problem.
Rap alone, cause we don't care about your lies and how you pack the chrome, pussies.
I ride a GSXR 1000. It's pretty much a cheater bike because you can wheelie it, like, there's no tomorrow.
I have a 99 R6.
That's the CBR 900. Not many people would recognize it as that at the state of its evolution. But that's my CBR 900. That one's the one I really love. It's a 92. It's an old school machine, but it rocks. It's just, it keeps on keeping on.
Come here. What are you doing? Okay, a rule of a wheelie is you throttle it, you let the clutch out, and you come up. Oh, do it! Let's go! No! That's the wrong way! Oh my God!
Mama do that?
My mom did that yesterday.
My worst accident, this was about 3 years ago, and I just fell over on a slow wheelie, which wasn't very slow back then.
I pull the thing up,
pull the clutch in, and it was sandy, I slipped.
And I just hung on and drove my shoulder into the pavement and broke my collarbone. And that's about the worst, which is not too bad.
I've attended four of them that are fatal, two of them with injuries. I've been in a few of them myself.
I must have slid about 30 feet and then hit the pole with my back like a twig. I basically went like that, bounced right off the fucking pole.
And now the brake's on good. And it freaking slammed me back down to the ground so hard, so fast.
A few bruises here and there, cuts and scrapes, but nothing really bad.
And I'm trying to stop. I think I'm saving this.
You know what, miraculously I was fine. It was painful, but not as bad. It was just a rookie mistake, I guess.
Wait a sec, the bike's right behind me, and I was like, pow! The bike runs over me, rips me apart. Just heavy machines, man. When you're on the ground, the bike runs when you're over. It's a bad motherfucker.
It's not so much the stunt rider that's the problem, it's the poor drivers around the stunt rider that are the problem. Because just like riders can suffer from target fixation and then crash, so do car drivers. And if you've got some guy doing something beside you and you start paying attention to, you know, this guy doing this kick-ass stunt beside you, next thing you know, you're driving into the car in front of you, you're driving into another car. So you kind of get problems associated around with it, you know, whereas the rider says, I'm fine, I'm safe, I'm not doing anything, and I believe that. He probably isn't doing anything that's out of his skill range, but there's a lot of other idiots on the road that can't compete with, you know, someone with great skill beside them.
Highway wheelies, I guess that's where it all started.
I try to keep it off the street, maybe occasionally, but mainly in the parking lots and stuff.
As a police officer myself, I don't have a problem with stunt riders. If they keep it off the main streets.
I like to keep it to a confined area where I know my environment, I know who's coming, what's going on.
Well, I don't think it's stupid if you keep it off the streets. Dangerous, well, sure, it's a little bit dangerous.
I'm a little disappointed that not every police officer has the same view that I do when it comes to, say, enforcement. Because I know there's a lot of guys out there who get jacked up, who get ticketed, who get, you know, worked over. Why? Because maybe they're misunderstood. You know, if they're doing it somewhere, if they're doing it somewhere out of the way, and all of a sudden, you know, it's say a spot that everyone knows about, and then, you know, you get a couple cops who think it's going to be an easy time to make some easy statistics for some easy tickets, or maybe no insurance, or maybe stunting, or for whatever. It's a waste of time. Where is it in the public interest to be going after these guys, right?
Street stuff, power to you, man. You guys want to do it, that's all good, but, you know, it's not my thing. It's just, to me, it's just too unsafe, you know? I'm just too old for that shit, man. I'm just too old, that's all it is. I'm an old motherfucker. Mm-hmm. Yeah, schizo, yeah. Come on. Padded walls and shit, dark horses, Anakin and Rise, y'all. Yeah, fuck what y'all think. This is my world. I am yo. Verbal violence. Yo. They told me not to rock the boat, so I sank the ship. Took a stroll on thin ice with no plans to slip. Screaming up to God in heaven, no thanks for shit. I don't mind going to hell, I need companionship. I brandish it like it's my last chance to spit. So I approach the gates with the mic stand equipped. I hawk up my soul and spit it out the rhyme. Garb on opponents, no need to use up lines. With a wind at my back or a hurricane against me, my foes ain't felt enough pain.
The kind of thrill I get from stunt riding is totally different from what I've done before.
Oh, I just like it. It's fun. Sometimes if there's a crowd around, that's kind of pumps you up too, and being a bit of a show off and all. But I just sort of, it's just fun, and it's fun to practice new tricks and get them mastered. And with the way that I look, so I got with a sick tight click. Yeah, my turn. They said I couldn't do it unless I play by the book, so I got with a sick tight click. I'm like water in a bowl, my flow mode it still feels like, can't sleep, souls on my path, they haunt my night.
You get this satisfaction from people when they're liking it. You can tell, you look at the faces, they're clapping, you're doing a burnout.
That's the thrill for me, is trying to conquer new things and mastering balance techniques. And it's really, that's a main core deal of stunt riding.
Well, I think part of the nature of the sport is going to be, you know, exhibition, sort of, you know, show off what you can do, right? It's, who wants to do it if no one can see what you can do? In my face, if you need me, I know that
slay don't fit the mold, so fuck yeah. I won't play the role. Hell no, yo, motherfucker. I'll die with my middle finger up so I can mock the vultures. Don't pop box and blocks, just rock the culture. Slave race stakes with phrase conveyed. Pave ways, save days, break chains of slaves. I used to say fuck fate, it ain't my place to choose it. Now I rap in the mirror to face the music. This is hip hop forever, no part time love. Stage lights blaze bright with hard times done. Don't look like a rapper, yeah, I heard all the lip. So I asked Lenny Williams to tell me what's hip. No Gucci, no gimmick, and no street cred. No gunshot wounds, but I still bleed red. No coin, no bends, no hollow point lead. Just freedom, truth, knowledge, and a ballpoint pen. Y'all tried to stare me down, so I spit with rise. Now we're burning holes through y'all with all six eyes. They said I wouldn't make it with the way that I look, so I got with a sick tight click. Yeah. They said I couldn't do it unless I play by the book, so I got with a sick tight click. 54. They said I wouldn't make it with the way that I look, so I got with a sick tight click. Yeah. They said I couldn't do it unless I play by the book, so I got with a sick tight click. Yo, we dark horses, y'all. Y'all gonna say what you want. Yo, 50, come at me with your hearsay, man. That's why I brought Rise with me on the track. The Grayson. Matter of fact, that's why I brought Montana the whole 54 with me. Alliance Regiment. Can't forget the mastermind. Listen, Bond, this man. Music is not for children. This is grown man shit.
Where you at, Giant?
We're dark horses. We do not negotiate.
Solo.
We like the Nazgul and shit. We will never stop.
You know,
go. You will always speak.
Hold for that website.
Get a dictionary. 54. A time to rip records.
I've been riding for just over 3 years now, and this will be my second year stunting. I got involved through fifth gear.
I've been stunting for about 3 years, and I got into it just by starting to wheelie a bit on the highway and saw some videos and thought stuff was cool, so just sort of continued on with it and progressed to where I've gotten so far, which is not far enough, but it's getting there.
I guess it's kind of weird. I just started messing around on bikes, you know, probably, you know, I don't know, it's got to be 5-6 years back now, when I've actually started wanting to do wheelies and started pursuing that. And I never really thought seriously about really stunting bikes until probably a few years back, 4 years or so ago maybe.
And haven't looked back.
Six phone calls, I'm like sleeping, Sat keeps phoning, I wake up, check my messages, it's like message 4, Sat, coming over, fucking get your bike out and shit. Trying to sleep, fuck off.
Within 5 years, I think the sport is gonna go pretty far. In the last 2 years, it has grown a lot, like competitions, everything. A lot of guys are getting majorly sponsored. You know, people are starting to realize that, you know, when you take it serious, it is a big thing.
Hopefully the sport grows. Maybe they'll have an X Games type deal with it. You know, who knows? I mean, it's getting pretty big. And
probably maybe 10 guys in the world making a living doing it. But I think it's kind of, if X Games starts promoting, I think X Games will be a big thing for any extreme sport. I think as soon as it hits X Games, then it will become mainstream. More people start seeing it, and you can get corporate sponsors, stuff like that.
I'd like to see this shit rocking X Games is what I'd like to see, because that's where it really belongs. Because this is an extreme sport. It's completely out of the norm. It's taking a vehicle and doing something that it was completely not designed to do and doing some cool stuff.
It'll break out sooner or later. It's going to be part of the X Games. It's going to be part of, you know, some motorcycle events, and you'll see it. It'll go big. Guys will start making big money. And all the people who are doing it now probably are just going to be the grandfathers talking about how they used to do it in some back parking lot, while some guys are doing it in stadiums now making $1 million.
You know, we want to show the public that it is a sport, and we do want it to grow.
underground is cool, but there ain't no money underground. It's underground because moles are underground. They ain't gonna go. The money is mainstream. These guys, everybody's selling videos. They're all about the videos, man. And that's an attempt to step to the mainstream, to get out to the masses. Because the masses buy the stuff, that's when all the money starts coming in.
I think I'd go with the big balls, because a lot of guys that do big sprockets usually don't do shit with the bike for a long time. Guys have more balls than skills, usually tend to learn a bit faster.
Both. You need both. Bigger sprocket helps out a lot to slow you down, and you gotta have big balls, I guess. I don't know, it comes naturally to me, so I don't seem to be scared on too many tricks, so you just gotta go for it.
Bigger balls. You got the balls, you can do it, man. Sprock is just for fucking the wusses to make it up happen.
It takes more skill to learn to master a big sprocket than it does to master a small sprocket and go fast with big balls. That's all it is. Skill versus balls.
I'd say big balls. And even with a bike with a big sprocket on the back, you still got to be able to hit the throttle hard enough and dump the clutch quick enough to get it up. They don't wheelie automatically and for free when just because you put a sprocket on doesn't mean you can wheelie it.
Oh, you're bleeding?
No, my shirt.
What's
my hand?
Oh,
okay.
That's okay.
You
get that on tape, Pat?
Part of it.
Fuck!
Yeah.
seems like everybody's got an opinion these days. Fuck off. Y'all need to voice that shit. All these problems, they're irrelevant. Unity's the key. Check it, man. You see, I can't understand why all these people are speaking. And all these people is beefing with no motive or even a reason. The streets is heated, it ain't even a season. So many people beefing, I'm surprised these people is breathing. And I can't believe half the shit these people believe in. With all this gun talk, I figured half these people be leaking. Or half these people be bleeding, cause these people ain't speaking. The jealous cowards I see scheming like the evilest demons. The MCs and people I'm seeing and everyone else. Fueled by greed, fuck y'all, I rap to better myself. And rap is better than wealth, I'll move forever in stealth. Don't know both them, but I'm a bit cocky and clever myself. Forget a job, I work at rap, cause I was made for a mic. Well, cats rap with houses worth more than what I'm making my life. I'm able to fight, and ain't trying to get slayed with a knife. And no more favors, cause favors is always paid with a price. And I'll admit it, these cats' fairy tales and fables is nice. See, words don't gamble with his life, go ahead and play with the dice. So listen, cause I'll say it once, I ain't saying it twice. Used to respect Kano and listen when he gave me advice. And I don't care about the chains and the ice, some brains will suffice. Through all this beef, I pray that being famous is nice. Sometimes I think to myself and dream being famous is like a dream come true, but that's from watching too much cable at night. These cats were wondering who gave them the right to say my name and play with the mic. They go around and say what they like. Dude, this juvenile behavior is like the worst thing that I seen happen, so I dropped the track, making it right. Plus I'm hungry, eating sick MCs in a beat. What kind of cheese, making 26 cheese in a week. See these MCs in the street, it's way too easy to beat. And fuck this Kano beef, let's leave it so the people can speak. All these cocksucking rappers got the cheek full of meat. You wanna battle me? I got a whole sheet full of heat. See, I'm evil and these people's too easy to defeat. You big purple fuck, when it's beef, you freeze in the street. So why the cats you working with? Say they squeezing the heat. You should take heed of these beefs and not be seen in the street. I'll be honest and straight up, the streets is pleased with your beats. But your partner's smarter than you, using his needles to speak. All your jealousy is feeble and weak. You won't attain the freedom you seek. And don't talk cause it's needless to speak. Yeah. That's the facts. Same beef with nobody. I ain't calling out anybody. I'm speaking on what's been going on. And somebody needed to step up and say something. Everybody's got beef. Everybody's so negative. Man, I got fucking people stalking me and shit. People showing up at my friend's house. This all needs to end, man. Despite how real y'all people think the streets is, man, this is music. If you ain't got a legitimate beef with a man, step the fuck back or you're just gonna look stupid, man. This is Hamilton. We need you to stand united, not stand divided.
Unmanned circle with the stocks. Woo! 360 stocking. Pow! That's my snipe show for the day. Thanks for coming out.
When are you gonna make a video instead of all those videos sitting there collecting dust on your shelf?
Yeah, one day.
Okay. You're watching. Stop, time out.
You dropped it on her. You left her there.
No, don't be scared.
Trauma.
Like head trauma.
That's gonna
be. No, it's not.
Come on, guys. You gotta give me something easy. Yeah. I'm just kidding. Throttle trauma.
Yeah. Be loud.
Got it? I'm set.
Ready?
Yeah.
One, two.
You're watching Throttle Trauma.
Well, I won't be speeding, hopefully.
No. If Dave gets a ticket, I'll pay for it.
Perfect. That's on film. Is that rolling?
Okay. I'll cover 50% of the ticket. Fine. No.
The whole thing, I heard it.
Turn this man, watch, he's gonna roll for days. He's a motherfucking crazy motherfucker.
He's gonna roll for days.
Did you get any of me in this suit?
Yes, faggot. Yes.
And no, it wasn't my bike, by the way.
Put it on.
Fuck, he uses it as a weapon too, eh?
Hey!
Zach!
Hey! Ah, turn around! Why are you taping? I'm not doing anything.
We'll just take your penis for a second.
No.
That'll be good. No. We'll post that up. And
no cack for you.
Yeah, no cack for you.
Hello. Hey,
give me a... Come on.
There was a ghost car right there with the lights on. We went through the intersection. I swear he was coming after us and he didn't. He went right through. We're all good.
Trippy Bill.
What do you think
back
of Jesus?
Mexican Jesus has work. Cool.
My sister.
Real cool.
What's cool?
Mexicano Jesus.
Oh, I'm putting your sticker.
I think something.
Somebody better get naked if it's gonna sell.
You guys are fucking ugly though.
News now. Come on, we got a story.
Wheel me around. Hurry up. Start wheeling me.
Oh, I don't know. You seem like you're setting stuff up.
No, I am.
Well, I don't. You just said hold on for a sec. All right, hold on.
I got the neck going there.
What are you laughing at?
Yeah, it's not funny.
He's, you know, he's disabled.
How is that? Matt made it.
I made it. It was all for you, Saturnin. I love you, baby.
Thank you.
Here's one.
Swig it.
I ain't no fucking swigger.
Swig it.
I ain't no swigger. What the fuck?
Yeah, you're a swigger.
God damn.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What? This is this one time me and Sad got drunk at his mom's house off his mom's wine.
Oh, I like it. Where's this
and,
going?
Sad passed out right away. He laid on his back, and I walked up to him. I pulled down my pants, right? Like, real oh, close, real quiet, like. And I put my nuts on his forehead, and all he did was smile. It was unbelievable. He's like, I love this. And then he's like, Johnny, don't hurt me, baby. Johnny, don't hurt me, baby. It was disgusting. And then his mom came out and was like, hey, Shane, I didn't know you were staying over this late. And that's that.
What happened, Skeeter?
Whoops, there it is.
Yeah, that's what happens.
Fucked up on an endo.
Are you gonna do wheelie and endo?
Well, what you gonna do?
The fisheye? Is that what you got on
yes.
there? Why don't you make it the penis cam and put it in your pants?